online classes from June 1st onwards. This method of teaching arises thousands of questions in our minds. To clarify all our doubts and inquiries, we have our beloved principal, Ms. Sujitra R. So, let's speak to her.
Hi ma'am, how are you? Hope you're fine. Ma'am, can you please explain us about the online classes planned for us?
Fatima, I'm fine, thank you. As you know, this COVID-19 has made all of us to think different and act different. And as per the instructions of the government, June 1st onwards, all the school education will go online. So definitely we are also working to go online. And CBSE has given enough directions to all the schools by preparing the alternate academic calendar. And we have also given enough instructions to teachers, and we are ready with the digital content. We have done all the arrangements how to make the online classes very effective. I hope it will work out well.
So which platform are we going to use for the online classes?
The platform that we are going to use is our school mobile app. The teachers will be transferring the content in the form of PDF or some images or files through the school mobile app. And for live classrooms, we will be depending on the Zoom app. And for higher classes, especially for higher classes, for submitting or for giving the assignments, our teachers will be using the Google Classroom app as well. So all these platforms will be used for transferring the mobile content to the students.
Ma'am, do you think this virtual classrooms can replace our physical classrooms?
Definitely no. Virtual classrooms will not replace the physical classroom. Because in the virtual classroom, we will be able to make use of only two senses. Whereas if effective learning to take place, you need to use all the five senses. And moreover, we don't know how long this COVID-19 situation will go on. But till that time, we cannot put the students to remain idle. So this is only a temporary adjustment. And as soon as the COVID situation is getting over, we will be going back to our normal classrooms. In the meantime, if we don't engage the students, it will be an injustice that we are doing to the present generation. That's why we are going online.
So ma'am, how can we access online content?
Well, you can enter into our school website www.progressive.edu.in and click on the parent login option. And with the help of the username and password which is given to you, you can log into it. Then you can access the online content. In case you are using your mobile phone, you have to install the mobile application in your phone. With the activation key, you can proceed on to the online contents.
Ma'am, what are the expecting challenges?
There will be many challenges. First and foremost, we are new to this kind of online system of education. So a lot of effort is needed from the parent side, teacher side, and also from the student side. And the second thing is we are living in a rural area, and definitely the internet connectivity or the range issues will be there. And not only that, from one family, there will be two or three students attending the school, so there will be less number of devices available for the students for the online classes. So we have tried a level best to prepare a timetable in such a way that there is no clash between each classes that we are going to give. And also, in case such a clash arises, the students can contact the teachers and they will be given enough instructions how to follow the online classes. And apart from these things what I have mentioned, definitely there will be some more challenges, and as we go practical, hope we will be able to find out suitable solutions and go ahead.
We used to complete our arts fest during the month of July. So what's our plan this year?
Yes, you're right. We will not be able to conduct the competitions by this July. So what we have planned is, the first 5 days in the week, we will be going for the regular classes, and every Saturdays will be utilized to conduct the competitions for the students online. I hope it will work out well. I request all the students to participate wholeheartedly and make this online competitions a grand success.
What about attendance? Is it compulsory? How can you ensure attendance of students in online classes?
No doubt, attendance is compulsory. Just like every year, CBSE has issued instructions this year also that 75% of attendance is necessary for a child to get promoted to the next higher class. Since we are using the school mobile app, we have the facility to check the attendance of the students. And not only that, the online contents what the teachers are uploading, we have a feature in our mobile app to ensure how much time each child has put in to watch that particular content. So definitely in that way we will be able to ensure the attendance of students.
Ma'am, what is your expectation from the side of students and parents about this?
As you know, during the lockdown period, we had conducted many online tasks for the students. Our students have participated in it very actively, and as part of the task, many number of videos were created by the students, which is already uploaded in the Facebook. And inspired by all these online tasks, our children even have prepared, created their own YouTube links. So I think we will be able to get a good response from the students and parents. At this juncture, I would like to thank all our students, teachers and parents who participated wholeheartedly for the grand success of the online task program that we conducted. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much indeed for your valuable information. We promise you to do our best. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, dear students. Thank you, Fatima, Zeeshan, Rehan, Shahbaz, Faiza, and Misbah. And thank you, all of you. Wishing you all a very good academic year ahead.